Welcome to the Better Relationships Podcast with Dr. Dar Hawks, the Relationship Healer. Here you'll find the advice and insights you need for a healthy, happy, and harmonious relationship. Dr. Dar specializes in helping heart-centered women and their partners connect on a deeper level. Through her guidance, couples can learn to see, hear, understand, and support each other in ways that truly matter. To kickstart your journey towards a better relationship, visit needs.drdarhawks.com to identify your dominant primary relationship need. Today, we're talking about being lazy. It's not what you think it is. I want you to stop accepting being lazy as a judgment. I'm going to share with you why. We grew up in a generation that looked down on laziness. This has resulted in pushing ourselves and pushing others, pushing to improve our weaknesses or theirs, pushing to make ourselves achievement-oriented, pushing them to be achievement-oriented, pushing ourselves and them to make more money, pushing ourselves and them to compete, pushing to stand out in our work and family life, pushing for acceptance, pushing to change ourselves to fit in, pushing to be powerful and feel empowered, pushing to feel good, pushing for accomplishment. These are just a few examples of the pushing energy that's so prevalent and rampant in our society and culture today. The health ramifications are now being revealed for the pushing mindset that has creeped into just about every family and anywhere humans congregate. This sadly has resulted in humans showing that they are constantly busy. This constant state of busyness was and is still valued in the workplace, and then it's brought home as a good thing, so we stay looking busy. Technology also helps us look busy. Putting our face in front of a laptop, a tablet, or a cell phone, those all make us look busy, especially when other people can't see our screen and we have a poker face based on whatever we're looking at. And we're not, you know, emotionally expressing what we're watching or reading on those devices. But really, all those devices are just distractions, and the use of them is a direct result of the addiction to being busy, in my opinion. Let's face it, busyness equates to distraction. It keeps us from connecting with each other. It keeps our minds busy. It keeps us from having to feel. It keeps us disconnected from the world around us. And dare I say it, virtual reality is not reality. Neither is reality TV. Engaging with your physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual world is a key to yours and our well-being. But I digress. Back to the word lazy. Throwing the word lazy around as a judgment of a person's qualities is irresponsible, dishonoring, and frankly mean-spirited. In fact, the word lazy, according to the Oxford Dictionary, means an unwillingness to work or expend energy, characterized by a lack of effort, care, or activity. But the word lazy is thrown around as a generalization, judgment, and criticism of a person's character and identity. For those of us who are sensitive to criticism, this is an emotionally damaging word to describe us. Let's be honest here. When people use the word lazy to describe someone, it just means they're not getting what they want from the other person, and perhaps even in the way they want it done. Bam, I said it. And when we call ourselves lazy, it just means we are not going to push ourselves to do something someone else wants or has taught us we must do, because we're not feeling it, we're not inspired, and most likely we were told what to do and how to do it. That's not inspiring. If we all just learned how to kindly ask for another person's help instead of telling each other what to do, there'd be a whole lot more joy and collaboration going on. As human beings, we're more inspired to help when we're asked for help. We're more inspired to participate and engage when we're asked to help. Today, ask others for their help. Here's an example. I'd like your help with taking out the trash bins to the curb now. Do you have a moment to help me with that? I'd like to focus on getting supper ready while that is taken care of, as I just can't fit another thing in the bin. And when it's done and they've done it, say, oh my gosh, I really appreciate you doing that, because now supper's on the table for us to enjoy now. That was not so freaking hard, was it? More asking for help, less telling others what to do, less yelling when it's not done. Telling leads to yelling. Asking leads to helping. Helping leads to connection. Connection leads to collaboration. Collaboration leads to community. Community leads to belonging. Belonging leads to feeling and being loved. It's all connected. That's my message for today. Being lazy is not a bad thing. It just means we're not inspired. So find your inspiration, and one way to do that is to learn what motivates you through learning about your relationship superpower. There are 5 of them, and I invite you to take the relationship superpower quiz at drdar.com and go take the quiz, learn what your superpower is. And in the spirit and honor of asking for your help, ask your friends and family to take the quiz. Then you can start talking about your relationship superpowers that you've learned, and you can talk about your kryptonite, because we also have kryptonite. And when laziness creeps in, usually our kryptonite has been activated and triggered. So go take the quiz now, ask your friends and family to take the quiz if you would, and start talking about your relationship superpower and your kryptonite in your family and friend community. It is powerful, it's fun, it gives you both a similar framework and language to use and to talk about it without having to take a deep dive into your feelings and upsets and lack of inspiration, or even using the word lazy. Remember, it's all connected, and asking is inspiring. Asking for help is inspiring. If you found today's episode helpful, please subscribe to the Better Relationships podcast on your favorite platform and share it with your friends and family. Remember to take the Primary Relationships Needs Quiz at needs.drdarhawks.com to better understand your unconscious needs and unlock better communication so that you and your partner see, hear, understand, and support each other in having a healthy, happy, and harmonious relationship that lasts. I invite you to share your thoughts and comments with me on your favorite platform, or DM me on Facebook at Dr. Dar Hawks1, where I share more tips on how to be seen, heard, understood, and supported in your relationships.